Hello, I'm Marco, and this is the Shadow Focus. And the purpose behind creating this channel was just so that I could analyze film, video games, and literature, as well as look at themes, motifs, symbolisms based off my personal experience and my personal outlook. And the film in question today is going to be the 2018 coming-of-age story called Mid-90s. And this is Jonah Hill's directorial debut, and it was released by A24, which is one of my favorite production houses, and this just so happened to be one of my favorite films of that year. So I would just like to take a few minutes just to talk about this film's portrayal of pain and the inclusiveness of it, as well as the importance of having a support group. So I have to give a spoiler warning and ask that anybody who hasn't seen this film, go ahead and click out of the video and do yourself the favor of watching it. And whoever's left, let's go ahead and get into it. Mid-90s is a small-scale film which follows a young man named Stevie who is abused at home and is looking for an outlet. And that outlet is revealed to be the skating community in his town. And it is in this community that he finds the group of people that would end up being his closest friends. They end up a tight-knit group, and you know, they do everything together. They ride their skateboards together, they smoke together, they get high together, they get drunk together. And that's pretty much the entirety of the film in a nutshell. The majority of the cast is pretty much based around this group of skaters, which is led by a young man named Ray, who is pretty much the glue of the group holding everybody together, who has aspirations of being a professional skateboarder someday. So he takes skateboarding seriously. It's fun for him, but it's also something that is a means to an end. He's trying to make a career out of it. And followed by that is going to be his closest friend, which is his name is going to be called Fuck Shit. And Fuck Shit is going to be the more laid-back character in the movie. He's more interested in where the next party is than he is about skating. And next is going to be their group cinematographer, who's called Fourth Grade, which is a jab at his mental capability. And what he does is he records every moment that they're together on his cheap camcorder. And because he has aspirations himself of being a director someday. Next is going to be Ruben, who's going to be the second youngest person in the group. And he is shown to be, you know, more of a hothead and a bit more immature. And lastly, and it's going to be the newest addition to the group, is Stevie, our main protagonist. And well, Stevie is kind of a blank canvas at when he's introduced in the film, because, you know, like most of us, he's a 12, 13 year old. He doesn't really know, you know, how to fit in. He doesn't know his taste of music. He's still figuring that out. He doesn't know how he wants to dress. He doesn't know really what he wants from life. I would not call myself a skater. I'd be lying. But there was a point in my childhood when I really did enjoy riding my skateboard. Even though my skateboard was a cheaply bought Walmart piece of wood with flimsy screws and really bad artwork, I still took the time every day to go outside and skate and get up every time I busted my ass. I wasn't good, didn't know any tricks, but it was still, you know, a fond hobby of mine. And, you know, as time passed by, I rode less and less, but I was still always very interested in the skate scene itself, and I like to watch people skate. I think it's very interesting. And, well, that's really what reeled me into this film, was a nostalgia of remembering skateboarding every day in the hot sun and bleeding and, you know, getting the wind knocked out of me every time my back hit the concrete. And what made me stay was this film's dive into pain. And you know, that's what I'm gonna talk about in the next section. This film does such a good job at showing that all pain, even if it isn't, you know, as bad as yours, should still be taken seriously, and it should be okay to talk about it. And we all have traumas in life that we go through, and so we shouldn't feel afraid that our trauma isn't as bad as somebody else's. And at the same time, if you've gone through, you know, horrible situations and have horrible, you know, things that have happened to you in the past, you shouldn't invalidate somebody else's feelings because, you know, what happened to them wasn't as drastic as yours, because, you know, that isn't right. It is the people we surround ourselves with that dictate whether or not we can achieve this kind of openness and understanding. Because even if your friends and family don't understand exactly what you're going through, it's still very vital to have somebody there to listen and not scrutinize you. Although the guys in this film are constantly, you know, roasting each other and calling each other a bunch of slurs, bullying each other pretty much, it is still clear that they do have, you know, endearment for each other and they care. Also, there are times where in life we feel like our existence is the worst, And, you know, that's just pretty much the name of the game when it comes to the human brain, because that's just the way we're wired. But this film reminds us that sometimes, even no matter how bad it gets, it could always be worse, much worse. And I'll let Ray from this film go ahead and explain it himself.
A lot of the time, we feel like our lives are the worst. But I think if you looked at anybody else's closet, you wouldn't trade your shit for their shit.
To further explain his point, he even, you know, jumps into all the traumas and inner struggles that the other members of the group are going through, and even goes as far as, you know, giving out details of how he lost his brother to a hit and run. He does all this just to let Stevie know that even if, you know, the other guys in the group don't understand exactly what he's going through, they'll still be there to pick him up. And that's what really matters. So, in conclusion, although this film is considered a film where technically nothing actually happens, I feel like there's a certain deepness in it that can only be told through this, you know, kind of chaotic randomness that is this film. It is, after all, the story of a boy trying to find his way in a world that he doesn't truly understand. So that's pretty much it. And, you know, if you sat through that, I really appreciate it. And, you know, if you like the video, go ahead and like and subscribe to the channel. Also, you know, if you have any ideas for what my next video should be, or if you have a certain talking point that you would like me to talk about, go ahead and leave it in the comment section and I'll take that into consideration. Also, if you guys have any tips for me or any, you know, improvements that I can make to my channel, go ahead and leave them in the comment section. I'll gladly read through them. And, you know, until next time, thank you.